do an upcoming as well?
Yes, it is also down to me. Sorry, 137 Arkwrights, there is an addendum, update sheets. There was additional consultation responses from the council's waste team, who raised no objection essentially. Application at 137 Arkwrights, land adjacent to 137 Arkwrights. This is quite complicated, so I will spend quite some time going through the presentation. So, application site falls between 137 Arkwrights and 136 Arkwrights. And this area here is the green wedge, and the application site is here. You'll see from this plan there is different character of the properties which 136 Arkwrights forms in terms of the south and west, and then the properties to the north, which are 137 Arkwrights and to the north. So the site is essentially in the middle here. You can see the application site. 136, 135 Arkwrights face the site, and all of these are staggered, 142, etc. They're all two-storey houses. These ones along here, you'll see when I get to the photographs, are two-storey with a pitched roof. 136 onwards down here are L-shaped with a flat roof and modernist, so there's quite a distinction in character along Arkwrights. The existing site, which is garden, you see that more in the photos. Existing elevations of the existing property, you can see we have this rendered panel on one end and render at the rear. So the proposed site plan is to set a property at the back here, just a bit more detail, first floor, and this shows the elevations in terms of how they fit in terms of the adjoining property at 13. This is 137 Arkwrights. This is the new property. You can see it's at a similar height, similar shape and size, with a similar gap as the adjoining property. The difference is where it's actually sited, and this plan actually shows the relationship to 136 Arkwrights. This application also follows refusal of an application. The new scheme is 3.3 metres further back than this scheme, and there's been improvements in terms of landscaping, and also we now have biodiversity net gain contribution. So, looking at the photos, as I said, we've got Arkwrights, these properties with the white render elements to them, and this is the bit of the road, the site is here, and this is looking back towards the southwest. You can see these flat roof properties which are sort of L-shaped. You can see in the north these properties staggered with these prominent rendered panels. The application would repeat this, but as I said, the stagger is different, shows the application site, so the dwelling would go beyond. This is 137, so we'll sit back further in the site, and this is 136 Arkwrights. 13, this shows probably a bit more clarity, a bit more detail. Shows this window and this window are bedrooms. This is also a bedroom, it's obviously further back. And again, bedrooms, this is 135. The dwelling proposed would be set back, essentially. This shows the relationship. I should get to the relationship in terms of the proposal. So the main issues here are the principal. The impact on the character and appearance of the area, and the impact on number 136 Arkwrights. So, in terms of the principal, there's two issues here. The loss of open space in terms of whether it is open space in terms of policy PL6, as I mentioned earlier, and then whether infill development is appropriate in terms of policy H2. Taking PL6, as I said before, we're very proud of our incidental open spaces that form part of the landscape character of Harlow, and that's intrinsic to the character. However, this site doesn't form part of that character. It's a green area separating two distinct housing types. Towards the north, you've got these two-storey pitched, detached, staggered ones with the rendered panels to the north. And then to the south, you have these two-storey with a flat roof with modernist design. So it's considered that it does not form part of this intrinsic character of Harlow in terms of other open spaces. So as most no open space would be lost, it's not part of the character of the state, so therefore it, policy PR6 wouldn't apply. So therefore the principle comes down to policy H2, where infill development is acceptable in principle if it does not harm the character of the area, has sufficient parking, has sufficient refuse position, and does not harm the potential for other developments. And I'll go through those issues in a bit more detail. So taking the impact on the character of the area, the proposal follows the design to the north, as I've shown in terms of this elevation. You can see that it is of similar brick, has timber panels, white render on the side of the elevations, and then we render on the rear. The difference is the siting, it's slightly further back in the site, further 4.5 metres back. Design would follow that design to those in the north. So overall it would work in terms of the overall character and appearance of the areas on that issue. It's considered to be acceptable. Coming on to the impact on neighbouring amenity, the issue here is the issue with regards to the impact on 136 Arkwrights, as I showed in terms of the relationship. So you can see here, you have the outline of 136, the L-shaped, and it has two windows. There's one window at first floor and one window at ground floor. You can see that window is located to the front of the front wall of the proposed at 136. And the distances, we're talking 5.4 metres in terms of here and 6.7 metres here. So the issue is whether that relationship would cause harm to the amenity of that residence. So in terms of outlook, the question is whether there'd be a significant sense of enclosure by reason of this build, of this new dwelling you put there. And as I've said, you've got quite a significant distance, and in this window is to the front, and it's also a slight angle. So therefore, in terms of overdominance, it's not considered the two-storey dwelling in this location will be overdominant to somebody living within 136 Arkwrights. In terms of sunlight and daylight, a detailed sunlight daylight assessment has been submitted, and that shows that all neighbouring properties would meet the target of 27 vertical sky components or the 80% reduction. So in terms of sunlight, it's considered to be acceptable. In terms of privacy, there are no windows on this side of flank elevation, and this property would look primarily to the front of the property. So in terms of privacy, it would be considered to be acceptable. So on the basis of those issues, the overall recommendation is to grant. Thank you.
Thank you, Kevin. We have one speaker, which is Shirley Burkett, which is against it. We have.
Right up near to the corner, which adjoins the gates on the side. upstairs bedroom will be looking out still to a brick wall. It was declined planning last year because it had a more of an impact, the brick wall. It has been moved back, but now by moving it back, the corner is now adjacent to our side access, and the side access is going to, I feel that the whole building will be overpowered. The outlook that we, everybody's enjoyed at Arkwrights, that large piece of green to the front of both properties, the removal of all the trees, but we've still got trees, we've still got hedgerow, and as people drive around, it looks absolutely beautiful. The house, I still don't think looks anything like the rest of that road. It certainly doesn't, it's not expected to look like 136 onwards. But I do believe it will have a huge impact on our lifestyle in a house that we have been very, very happy. And we look after all the ground outside, also 137, because it's a rented property. We clear the litter, we keep it nice, and I just feel that it shouldn't go ahead. That's all I've got to say.
Thank you. Next, questions and clarifications? No? Debate? Ladies first?
Yep.
Chief. This is debate. Is it debate or questions?
Debate.
Okay.
Is that right?
Yep, that's fine.
Oh yes, sorry. Well yes, I'm very sympathetic to 136. And I think reading through the application, I agree with the civic society in a sense that, I mean, this is a lovely area. And there are design principles, and although they're different ends, that was Gibbon's original design, and so it's not that it's an anomaly in any way. It's a deliberate design, and I agree with the civic society who say that the original objections for refusal have not changed greatly. Changes are marginal, not enough to convince me that it's still there. Apart from the ground refusal being overbearing and very close to 136, and as the lady has explained, that will completely change that lifestyle. Gap is marginal. There is a loss of green space. I'm concerned that the trees were felled. A lot of trees have been felled already, which really disturbs me. So apart from the loss of green space, there's also more a loss of further trees. And the car parking, which we haven't really explored, we've got an extra 5 people. It's going to add to the car parking problems, which are there. So, all in all, I would agree with the civic society's overview.
Thank you, Councillor Carter.
The distance, the 6.7 metres and 5.4 metres, which in planning terms might be sufficient, but I think if you're living in a property, that's not really very far at all, is it? And just completely understand, you know, this isn't a new build area or a new, as they would term it, a village.
It is a very significant area, in as much as you've got those two rows of detached or linked detached houses, each with their own style, running around. But there is a change, and wherever you have a change, you've got to have a boundary. And as the design before tonight, one of the existing rows, all of which are staggered, all of which are offset, and in fact, the houses to the southern side, 1, 5, 6, 1, 3, 6, downwards, or 1, 3, 6, 1, 3, 5, 1, 3, 4, are all staggered at sort of in different positions. So the inclusion of an additional property will, if you like, complete that form, because at the moment you've got one row of houses, one row of houses, but they're not linked up. And putting out another house, which looks like 1, 3, 5, will fill that form. What else have we got? So, you know, as it's presented tonight, I wouldn't have a problem about approving it.
Anybody else? We go to the vote, which is on page 144, and that is to grant permission. All those in favour? Mrs. Granton? No. All those against? So that's, thank you very much. It's gone. References from other committees. There are none. Any other business? Well, just one. I'd like to, as a personal, I've known Jean and Bob on the planning committee for quite a few years now, and I always appreciate, well, I've only just taken over as chair, I was chair many years ago, but I appreciate their contribution. It's always valuable. And we shall miss you. And you talked to the full council the other day about sitting on the cloud, watching us. But don't go there too quickly. All right? So, but from my point, I think we all agree. Thank you very much for all you put into the planning committee over the years. Which you've probably been on it as long as I have, one side or the other. But, so wish you well in your retirement.
And,
thank you. Thank you. Close the meeting at 7:03. Thank you.